To add a point line or polygon to your map, you're going to tap on the little gear wheel button in the bottom right of your map. That's going to open up a variety of options. We're going to choose the bottom option, the draw tool button. And then that's going to open up all of our points, lines, and polygons we can place on the map. In this example, I'll go ahead and place a house on the map. So I'll slide over, I find the house icon, and I tap on it. And now on my screen, I'm presented with a couple of options. I've got a blue halo with a white X in the middle of my map. Down at the bottom of my screen, I also have a current location option. So if I'm out on site and I'm standing right next to the house, I can just choose current location. It'll drop a house right where I'm standing. If I want to manually place a house on the map, all I need to do is I'm going to move the map itself until the center of that white X is right on top of the structure. I then tap on the map inside that blue halo, and that's going to place the icon on the map. Once I see the icon placed on the map, I'll tap on the green done button in the bottom right, and now we have a house placed on our map. The same concept holds true if we're drawing out a point or a line or a polygon. It's the same process, really. So I'll draw out a polygon real fast to show you how that works. Once again, I'm going to tap on the little gear button in the bottom right. I'll choose the draw tools option, and then I'm going to choose the red dash boundary. If I'm out on site and I can walk around the perimeter of the field or the tree orchard or the timber stand, I can actually use that current location button again to make drawing this out really easy. Essentially, as I'm walking around, I just continue to tap the current location button and it'll draw out the polygon or the line in the same shape as I walk around. If I want to do this manually, you can see I've got that blue halo with the white X in the middle of my screen, and I move the map itself to the corner where I want to start drawing, and I tap inside that blue halo, and now I'm drawing, and I'm just going to continue to move the map around, and I tap using the center of that white X to determine the shape of the polygon or the line that I'm drawing. And once I've drawn out that shape and I'm happy with it, I can then tap on the green done button in the bottom right, and it'll finish the shape out. After I've drawn these points, lines, or polygons on my map, if I want to change the name or the color on them, I simply tap on the item on the map. And just a side note, we can see interesting information about this boundary regarding the acreage and the perimeter distance. If I wanted to change the name to an orchard and maybe change the boundary to green, I'll tap on that little pencil icon you can see to the right of the boundary name. This gives me my editing options, and then I just tap into each one and I fill them out correctly. When I've got the new name and the color, I'll tap on the Save Tool button in the bottom right, and that will then save the updates to that particular item. That is how we can add points, lines, or polygons to our map, and we can also then change the name and the color on them.